Every game starts with an idea. However, a lot of times, coming up with good ideas seems hard and almost impossible to do. We tell ourselves everything has already been done. The important thing to remember here is that as time passes, every year, we see new and different innovative games coming out. This means we need to realize there are good ideas out there. All we need to do is to find them. In today's video, I want to talk about the best tips to come up with game ideas. The first tip is to play a lot of games. This one is really obvious, but very important. You have to play a variety of games to get an idea of what is out there, what interests you, and what you think might be a good mechanic to use in one of your games. Also, by playing a different variety of games, it will allow for you to think about interesting ways of merging different genres. This leads me to the second tip, which is combining two or more different game genres. This is a great tip because it allows you to think outside of the box and think about crazy combinations that might make a great game. The best example of this to me would be Rocket League, which is a game that combines car racing with soccer. It became successful, and to this day, is still played by millions of people, even though the game is already 5 years old. The third tip is to explore the world around you. Every time you go explore the city or go out with friends, be really aware of your surroundings and what is happening around you. When you least expect it, there can be a game idea in your sight. A great example of this is Pac-Man, which came to be when the developers were eating pizza and they ate one slice. Pac-Man was staring at them right then and there. The fourth tip is to constrain yourself. Normally, when we are free to think about anything we want, our minds can get overwhelmed and blocked because there are infinite possibilities. A great way of dealing with this is putting some constraints on the exercise. What I mean with this is every time you have a brainstorm session, there is some kind of constraint that limits what you can think of. For example, one constraint will be maybe choosing a theme. Is it a sci-fi game or is it a pirate game? Or maybe choose a genre. Is it a third-person shooter or an RPG? Those constraints will allow you to focus your mind on one thing and will for sure help you come up with great ideas. The general idea is not to think about any game in particular, to avoid stunting your creativity. The fifth tip is to study other mediums. There are other mediums like novels, movies, theater, etc. that have already told great stories in their own way. It's a great idea for you to actually learn about those mediums and study how they tell stories. Granted, there are different mediums. What works in a novel might not work on a game, because a game has interaction. Nonetheless, it can be a great source of inspiration for your game. One game that comes to mind based on a book is Dante's Inferno. Although the game is very different to the book in tone, it for sure helped the developers as a springboard to start developing that game. The sixth tip is to mess around in Unity or whatever engine you use. Sometimes, when we're learning an engine, crazy things can happen. We can get funny bugs that might later become features, even if they don't seem like it. Just messing around and testing things, even if they don't make sense or just for fun, can be a great exercise. Take Goat Simulator as an example. That game is hilarious, and probably a lot of what happens came out from just experimentation in the engine. The seventh tip is to use a game idea generator. I admit this can be silly, but sometimes you might luck out, and with some changes, it can turn into a great game idea. It might even give you something that you're not thinking about, such as the missing puzzle to your game idea. I'm going to link in the description a few of these. Feel free to experiment. It might be worth it for you, especially if you're stuck and don't know where to start. The eighth tip is to participate in game jams, even if it's just by yourself and you don't submit anything. Game jams are events in which people come together and create a game in a few days. What is great about most game jams is that there is a theme. This means that the game that you create has to in some way represent that theme. It can be literally or in an indirect way. This theme helps constrain you in what you're thinking about making, and can be a great way of kickstarting your brain into thinking about game ideas. Doing game jams with people can also help. There is a different energy when you work with other people. It's cool to be pushing each other in order to create something amazing together. The ninth tip is to play with toys or Legos. I have found that playing with toys, especially Legos, is a great way to get creativity out. Even if you're not building anything in particular and are just freely playing. Doing this allows for your brain to get in motion and just start thinking about things. Whenever you least expect it, a spark might hit you and your new game idea will come to mind as you play. The 10th tip is to journal your ideas, even when you're dreaming. Believe me, ideas come up whenever you least expect them. They can come up when you're in the bathroom, when you're taking a shower, or even when you're sleeping. You have to take note of each of those ideas right away if you don't want them to get away. A lot of times, it has happened to me that I have an idea and I say, I will write it down later, but then I forget. When I try to remember what it was, it's gone. Make sure to always journal your ideas and keep them safe. Later on, when you need some inspiration, you will have a band you can leverage, combine a few concepts you came up with, or even use it as a starting point for something brand new. As you can see, there are a lot of ways of coming up with great ideas for your games. However, keep in mind that the idea is just the first part in the development process. A great idea is not synonymous with a great game. You have to have good design, do a lot of playtesting, have a production schedule, among other things, to make a great game. Whatever happens, don't get discouraged if your game idea gets slammed by someone you respect or by your playtesters. Keep working on it, iterate, and soon enough, you will have a game that people can enjoy and have fun playing. And if you're stuck and have no ideas, just start working on something and it will come to you eventually. And that's it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. What other things do you do to come up with game ideas? Please let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you like this video, please subscribe and share it with your friends. See you next time!